गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबॉडी. आई नो एवरीबॉडी इज रेडी टू नो व्हाट इज आवर टुडेज लेसन. ओके, वी ऑलरेडी लर्न्ड सो मेनी लेसन्स ऑफ सेवन स्टैंडर्ड. आवर फर्स्ट लेसन ऑफ ज्योमेट्रिकल कंस्ट्रक्शन, देन सेकंड लेसन मल्टीप्लीकेशन, देन थर्ड इज एचसीएफ एंड एलसीएम वी ऑलरेडी लर्न. ओके, एंगल्स एंड पेयर्स ऑफ एंगल, ऑपरेशन ऑन रैशनल नंबर्स, इंडाइसेस. ओके, we already learn and we do study and also homework also. Okay, now today we will learn an interesting lesson, okay, which consists of pictures with the help with questions. Okay, I know everybody will enjoy this lesson. While looking the pictures you have to give answers. Okay, everybody is ready? Yes, I know everybody is ready. You know, okay, I will share my screen. I am from Adarsh Nagar Municipal English Upper Primary School. Myself, Ram Bankar. I am Standard 7th teacher. And everybody knows, mathematics, today's subject is mathematics. And topic, we will know after this slide. Okay, my dear students, now it's your role to give me answers. Okay, ready everybody? Okay, what is the first picture?
Yes, sir.
Tell me the name of first picture. Yes, first picture is square. And another, second picture is of?
Triangle.
Triangle, very good, nice. And the third picture is of, which is in black color?
Circle.
Very good, nice. And what is the fourth picture, which consists of pictures? Anybody can answer?
Rectangle.
Yes, it is a rectangle. But tell me the, you already learned in before standard. Now tell me the name of this picture.
Pictogram.
Yes, very good. This picture is of pictogram. Okay, very good. Nice answer. And the last one is fifth number picture.
Graph paper.
Yes, graph very paper. Good. It is graph paper. Okay, now move towards the next slide. Which picture is this?
Graph paper.
Yes. Yes,
graph paper.
Bars are given, correct?
Yes.
Bar graph.
This picture is of bar graph. So today we are going to learn about the bar graph. Okay. Which is a very interesting lesson, which will give a lot of information to you about the given data. Okay. Data means given information. Okay, there are so many things in the bar graph. We will learn gradually, one by one. Okay, what is the horizontal line called? What is the vertical line called? What was written on the right corner of the graph paper? What are the labels? Okay, labels at below the horizontal line label. At the left side of y-axis vertical line, we will learn by this next slide. Okay, my dear students, from this lecture, you will come to know, okay, that learning outcomes, graph paper consists of unit. Second, one unit is of 1 square centimeter. Each unit consists of 1 square centimeter. Next is point of origin, x-axis, y-axis, scale. Next one is need of single and joint bar graph. Why it is need of single and joint bar graph? Okay. Drawing bar graph on graph paper. We will know from this lecture. Okay, we move towards the next slide. Okay, my dear students, you are looking at the screen. That is the big picture of bar graph. Okay, bar graph is consist of so many boxes. Okay, that bold line shows us boxes are there. It means we can call it is grid or unit. Okay, we can easily see. Look, I will show you. This is one box, okay, which is given on the right side of this page, okay, in three colors, given units, okay. Normally, we will purchase bar graph from the shop that three types, okay, red, gray, and blue color, okay. So I have given that grids, okay, on the right side. It means you understood that what is unit, big unit, okay. One big unit, okay. Look at the next slide. Look at this big unit. Each graph paper consists of many units or grids. Second point, or we can say small boxes which measure in one square centimeter, okay. It means that one bold line to the next bold line, the distance is 1 centimeter, okay. Third point, look, every bold line on graph paper is drawn in a sequence of 1 centimeter. Every bold line, my dear student, every bold line on graph paper is drawn in a sequence of 1 centimeter. We will move toward the next slide. Look at, dear student, this is the bar graph. This is the starting of bar graph, how to draw. Whenever you are going to draw bars on the graph, you have to draw a horizontal line, okay, on the below side of the graph, okay. That horizontal line is called x-axis. That line, understood? This line is called horizontal line, is called x-axis. This is the x, okay. It means that the horizontal line is called the x-axis. Understood? As everybody understood, I know. And this one is the vertical line. The vertical line is called y-axis, okay. Vertical, this line, I will show you, this vertical line is called the y-axis, okay. And these two lines, x and y line, x-axis and y-axis, that two lines concurrent at a point, okay, which is the point. This is the concurrent point of x line and y line, okay. That point is denoted by O. It means it is the originating point, my dear student. Do you understand? Yes. The originating point is the concurrent point of x-axis and y-axis. Okay. It means y-axis is perpendicular to the x-axis. Okay. At the originating point. Okay. O. The numerical values of y-axis starting from this originating point O. Okay, we will try to take examples on the bar graph from next slide. Look. Now it is for you, students. You have to give me the answer. Are you ready? Interesting question is there,
yes,
on the screen.
Yes, sir.
Every big unit of graph is made up of dash. Every big unit made up
ten
of square centimeter, one square
ten
centimeter,
square centimeter.
Centimeter,
ten square centimeter. Okay,
ten square answer. Centimeter.
Ten another square student. One unit. Yes, the answer is correct. My dear student, one unit of bar graph is consist of one square centimeter. I already told you on this slide. My dear student, I already told you on this slide. Look at this. This is the unit. I have shown you here. Okay. That small, small boxes or which measures in one square centimeter. Okay. Understood? Okay. Listen properly and look at the screen. So the answer is option number 2, one square centimeter. Now, my dear student, this is the very interesting question. Example, a pictogram of the size and number of vehicles. These are the vehicles. You know, you are looking at the screen. There are vehicles given, bicycle, motorcycle, auto rickshaw, and bullock cart. That vehicles in a town. Okay. Town means a big village. It's called town. Is given below. Okay. These are all the vehicles in a big town. Taking one. Okay. Look at the second line. One picture, scale is given. Scale is given. Taking one picture is equal to 5 vehicles. Okay. It means the auto rickshaw is one. So you have to count it. 5 auto rickshaws. Okay. 5 auto rickshaws. It means one picture is of 5 vehicles. Okay. Write their number in the pictogram. The question is what? Write their number in the pictogram.
Pictogram.
Okay. That empty box. You have to write the answers in these empty boxes. How many vehicles? That is the question. That is the question. Yes.
Okay, sir. Okay.
We will come to know by the next slide. Okay. The solution is given here. Dear student, look. Types of vehicle. First column is of types of vehicle. Second column is of vehicles. And the third is number. Okay. Which are given answers here. Okay. Look at bicycles. How many bicycles are given? Six bicycles are given. Yes. Then here given number by calculating 6 into 5, that is 30. Okay. Why 5 is given? Anybody can answer me?
Because each vehicle is 5 vehicles.
Yes, yes. One picture scale is given. While giving answers of bar graphs or pictogram, you have to consider scale. What is the scale? One picture is equal to 5 vehicles. So we have to multiply by 5, the number. Okay. Which is the number of bicycles? 6. Then 6, 5 is 30. So total bicycles, how much? 30 bicycles in this town. Okay.
Yes.
Big village. In this big village, there are 30 bicycles. Now look at the second question. Motorcycle. Motorcycle, we can say it is bike. Okay. Motorcycle, bike. How many motorcycles are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 motorcycles are there. Then 5 is 25. Then again,
five is 25.
Correct, correct. Very good. Nice answer. Now the next
auto
vehicle
is equal to 5.
Very good, very good. Nice, nice. And the bullock cart?
Teacher, sir, 3 5 is 15 is equal to 15.
Yes, very good. Sharp students, very good, nice. There are bullock carts, okay? 3 bullock carts. It means 3 5s. 1 bullock cart, consider 5 bullock carts, okay?
5 bullets.
Means that, yes, 3 5 is 15 is the answer. Yes. Now, my dear student, we have to move towards the next slide. Look, this is the very important, my dear student. Look, why there is a need of bar graph? So that point will give you the answer. It can take a long time. It can take a long time to draw pictures. Okay. In this pictogram, my dear Swan, if you have to draw, then how many times you have to draw bicycles? There are 6 times. How many times you have to draw motorcycles? 5 times. In third picture, auto rickshaw 1 time. Bullock cart 3 times. It is time consuming, no?
3 times.
Yes, it is time consuming. Okay. Then could we give the same data or information without using pictures? Without using pictures, is it possible to give same data?
Yes.
This question. Yes, yes. Yes, we can show same data with the help of bar graphs in a less time. In a less time. So, my dear students, you come to know why bar graph is important. Why? Because bar graph shows same data with the help within a less time. Okay. Now look at the same example drawn with the help of this pictogram and the bar graph. On the left side of this screen, you will see the bar graph is given, and on the right side of this screen, you will see the pictogram. Okay, which is easy to draw in a less time.
Bar graph.
Yes, bar graph is easy to draw. You have to draw x axis, you have to draw y axis, then originating point O, and the you have to take scale pencil, okay, drawing the bars, okay, then you draw bicycles, how many bicycles, then draw the bar till 30, complete 30 bicycles, motorcycle till 25 you have drawn the bar. Then auto rickshaw, only 5 auto rickshaw there. You have to draw the bar till 5. Okay. Bullock cart. It means ho gaya complete. Okay. But in the pictogram, what is happening? You have to draw the bicycles. 1 bicycle, 2 bicycle. It takes 1 to 2 hours to draw sometimes. Okay. It is time consumed to draw pictograph. So, taking less time, we have to take information from bar graph. Okay. Now, students, we have to move towards the next slide. This is the interesting question, my dear student. Now, it's your time to answer the question. Which method is easy to draw and show given data in less time? Which method? First method is pictograph, and the second method is bar graph. Which method is easy to draw?
Bar graph.
Yes, very good answer.
Bar graph.
Very good. This is the answer. Okay. You have given my smart students. Very good. Nice answer. I will appreciate you all giving quick answers.
Okay.
Now we move towards the questions and answers on the bar graph. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Now look at the student. This is the data. And you have to carefully observe this. Okay. We will reading this question. Okay. The bar graph shows the maximum temperature in degree Celsius. Okay. In degree Celsius. You already know temperature is reading in degree Celsius. In different cities on a certain day in February. In the February month. Okay. Observe the graph and answer the question. Just you have to observe the graph and answer the question. Okay, look at the graph. By yourself, look at the graph. Okay, the graph is given on the screen. On the x-axis, what are given? Cities are given, names of cities, correct?
And
yes, names of cities. Panchgani, Pune, Chandrapur. Yes.
Chandrapur is links highest.
Yes, yes. Now look at the
Chandrapur.
Yes, look at the y-axis. What is given on the y-axis? temperature is given, okay? And look at the upper right corner of the page. This is very important, my dear student. Scale is given. Scale on yes. y-axis. One unit is equal to 5 degrees Celsius. Okay. The originating point is where? The originating point is O. 0 to 5 degrees Celsius. Okay. I will show you. Okay. 5 degrees Celsius, 10 degrees Celsius, 15 degrees Celsius, 20, 25, 35. Okay. These are the given degree Celsius temperature. Okay. Are you notice on the vertical line, that is y axis, there is a given one word. Okay. Temperature is given. Okay. Okay. Now look at the answers. Okay. Sorry, questions. Question number, how many questions are given? 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 questions are given on this bar graph. Okay. The first question is, what data is shown on the vertical and the horizontal line? What data? Data means what? Information.
जहाँ पर हमें नाम लिखा है सिटीज का ना उसको बोलते हैं हॉरिजॉन्टल लाइन और जो और जो स्ट्रेट लाइन खड़ा है जहाँ पे टेम्परेचर लिखा है साइड में उसको बोलते हैं वर्टिकल.
यस वेरी गुड नाइस बेटा नाइस वेरी गुड ओके द क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट डू यू अंडरस्टैंड द क्वेश्चन व्हाट डेटा इज शोन ऑन द वर्टिकल एंड हॉरिजॉन्टल लाइन द क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट इंफॉर्मेशन और डेटा इज गिवन. Okay, tell me on the x-axis which information given? Names of cities, correct? The answer is names of cities on x-axis and name and the temperature of cities given on the y-axis. That is the answer. Okay. Look at the answer on this the first question. Okay. Temperature is shown on the vertical line and the cities are shown on the horizontal line. That is the answer of first question. Now look at the second question. The second question is here. Which city had the highest temperature? Yes.
Chandrapur.
Tell me the name of city. Yes, Chandrapur. The nice answer. Yes, the nice answer. Okay. Look at the answer of the second question. The city of Chandrapur had the highest temperature. Very good. Nice answer. And the next question, third. Which cities had equal maximum temperature? Equal, huh? Not minimum temperature. Which cities had equal maximum temperature? Tell me the name of cities.
Nashik and Pune.
Nashik and Pune. Yes. The right answer. Nice. Nice students, very good answer. Okay, look at the question. Bar graph, my dear students. I will explain you the answer of this. I will explain you. Panchgani and Mathiran also same. Panchgani and Mathiran also same. But this is not the answer. Why? Because it is equal temperature, but it is minimum temperature. Okay. What is the question? Which cities had equal maximum temperature? This is the equal temperature also. And maximum temperature. So the answer is maximum temperature. Pune and Nashik cities have highest equal maximum temperature. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes, very good. Now the next question.
Yes, sir.
Fourth question.
Nashik and cities... Pune.
Okay, Nashik good. And... Which cities had... Now look at the next question. Which cities had a maximum temperature of 30 degrees Celsius? Which cities, it's a plural. Cities is a plural form. Okay. Cities had a maximum temperature of 30 degrees Celsius.
Nashik and Pune.
Nashik and Pune.
Nashik Pune.
Nashik and Pune.
No, sir. Panchgani and
Mathiran. 30 degrees Celsius. My dear students, 30 degrees. Okay, look at the answer. Fourth question. Look, fourth question. Pune and Nashik had a maximum temperature of 30 degrees Celsius. Correct answer, those students are given correct answer, okay? Now look at the next question. Look at the next question. Question number 5, last question of this bar graph. What is the difference between the maximum temperature of Panchgani and the Chandrapur? There is shown the difference. My dear students, the difference means we have to subtract from the highest value to the lowest value. Okay. Now look at the Panchgani and Chandrapur. Panchgani, where it is? Yes, this is the Panchgani and this is the Chandrapur.
Difference,
okay?
Of 10 degrees Celsius.
Yes. The Chandrapur is of? Chandrapur is of how much?
35 degrees Celsius.
And Panchgani is 25. Okay. 25
degrees Celsius.
Okay. 35 minus 25. Look at.
25
equal to 10. Yes. 35 minus 25. What is? 10. Zero. Sorry.
5 minus 5 is equal to 0.
Yes. 35 minus?
Is equal to 25.
1. What is the answer? 10. So answer is 10 degrees Celsius. Understood?
Yes.
We will see the answer on the next slide.
Yes, answer is correct.
The answer is given. The difference between the maximum temperature of Panchgani and Chandrapur can be calculated as difference in, okay? Chandrapur minus the temperature of Panchgani, 35 degrees Celsius minus 25. Answer is 10 degrees Celsius. You will notice here at the bottom, okay? Now, my dear students, we will move forward. The question is given on the screen. The names of the heads of the families in a village and the quantity of drinking water their family consumes in a one day are given below. Draw a bar graph for this data. Okay. Just like, please mute your mic. Your background music make noise. Okay. The heads of the family is given. Just like your dad is your family head. In the example also same, the heads of the family is given. Ramesh family, Shobha, Ayub, Julie and Rahul. How many families head are given? There are 5 families head are given, okay? And liters of water they used in one day. Ramesh family used 30 liters in one day. Shobha family used 60 liters in one day. Ayub family used 40 liters in one day. Julie family used 50 liters in one day. And Rahul family used 55 liters of water in one day. Okay. Do you see properly? Now we will see the next slide, which is drawn the bar graph. Now look, students, okay? This bar graph on the y-axis, what is given on the y-axis? Look at the labels.
Head
of the family.
Drinking water
in liters. Yes, drinking water in liters.
1 centimeter scale on x, y-axis. 1 centimeter is 10, is equal to 10 liters.
Very good, nice. That is I am going to tell you, but you have already told. Very good, nice. Scale is given 1 centimeter is equal to 10 liters. Okay. Now, my dear student, it is drawn. Okay. Now look at the first, Ramesh. What is Ramesh? How many liters did they use? 30 liters.
30 liters.
Okay.
Yes.
On the y-axis, there is given liters in, there is given water in liters. Okay.
Yes,
10 liter, 20 liter, 30 liter, 40 liter, 50 liter, 60, 70 liter water given. Okay.
Yes.
Ramesh family used 30 liter. Correct?
Yes.
You will see above 30 liter. Ramesh, 30 liter. Okay. Next. Shobha. Second. Shobha, how much liter they use? 60 liters.
Okay.
Yes. The bar is drawn till 60. Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Correct. That bar should be the correct.
Ayub is 40 liters.
IUB is 40 liter. Very good.
Yes. Julie is 50 liter.
Very good. And the Rahul is
55 liters. Liters.
Yes. Sorry. Rahul is of 55 liters, liters. Correct?
Yes.
Yeah, look at 55 and the 55. Okay, my dear students, while drawing the bar graph, when you take a bar graph, they are using pencil and with the help of scale, okay? Your plastic scale, yes. You use to draw. You have to consider proper, okay? Write properly bar graphs. Equal distance between two bar graphs and height of bar graph should be same. Okay. Now we will move towards the next slide. Points also important. We are reading questions and answers on the bar graph. That points also very important, my dear students. Okay. We learn scale, labels, x-axis and y-axis. Okay. I know some students have in their mind what is scale, what is labels, x-axis and y-axis. I have to give answers now. Look, the scale is the number that show the units used on the bar graph, okay? Scale kya hota? Scale is a number, okay? Scale is a number that show on the bar graph, okay? On the upper right corner of the bar graph. Now labels. Labels means what? Name. Written on the bold lines, names. Both the side of the bottom of the bar graph have labels. That tells what kind of data is shown, what kind of data. Jo data show kiya hai, that are called labels, okay? That is head of the families and drinking water in liter. These are the labels. Understood? Yes. Now, look at the third point, that is x-axis. Describe which each data point on the line represents. Okay. What data is representing on the graph that shows the x-axis? And the y-axis? Y-axis shows the numeric value. Numeric value means the numbers are given on the y-axis. Everybody notice from these two examples we already studied. Okay. Now it's time to take next slide. My dear students, look, students planted trees in 5 villages of Sangli district. You know, Sangli is a district in Maharashtra, okay? There are 5 villages. Make a bar graph of this data. Okay, scale is given already on y-axis. 1 centimeter is equal to 100 trees. Understood, that is very important scale. 1 centimeter is equal to 100 trees. Name of place. Dudgaon, Bagni, Satandoli and Astha and Kauthepiran. Okay. These are the names of villages in Dudgaon. How many trees planted? 500 trees. In Bagni, 350. In Satandoli, 600. Astha, 420. Kavitpuram, 540 trees are planted. Now, look at the bar graph which is drawn with the help of this data or information. Look, it is clearly, you will see on the x-axis labels are given, name of place. On vertical line label is number of trees. Okay, name of place Dudgaon. Dudgaon, first bar of this graph. First bar, Dudgaon. How many trees planted on Dudgaon? You will see on Dudgaon 500 trees. Okay. With the help of shown 500. Look at the scale on the y-axis. 100 trees, 200 trees, 300 trees, 400 trees, 500 trees, 600 trees. Okay. Okay. On Bagni, how many trees are there? 350. Okay. So the bar is drawn till 350 Bagni. Okay. Look this Bagni. This is the second village, Bagni. Drawn bar till 350. Look at the next Samdoli. Samdoli is the village in Sangli district. There are 600 trees planted. Okay, 600 trees planted. Look at the third bar of this bar graph. Samdoli, how many? 600 trees planted. The bar graph is drawn till 600. It means we will understood easily. There are 600 trees planted in Samdoli. Okay. The next is Astha. Look at Astha. 420. Astha. Okay. After 400, how many? 20. Then take small two lines. One line is of 10. Okay. It means 20. 420. Plants planted on Astha village. Okay. Look at the last Kautepiran. In Kautepiran, how many plants are planted? In Kautepiran, 540. The last bar graph. On the last bar graph, 540. Yes. The bar graph is drawn till 540. Okay. Which is nearer to 550. Okay. Okay. Now move towards the next slide. This is a very interesting question, my dear student. Now you have to answer me. Okay. Bar graphs are very important. Okay. Which shows the lot of information. Are you ready to give me answer?
Yes.
Yes. Look at the label. Sachin Tendulkar. You already know who is Sachin. Sachin is the which is in Indian people those like cricket. These people are called Sachin is the god of cricket. Okay.
Yes. Okay.
This information shows the Sachin Tendulkar's ODI run by calendar year. Okay. You know, okay. Calendar year 1989. Sachin Tendulkar started his career in 1989, my dear student. 1989, 1990. Yeah. Look at the x-axis. X-axis. Years are given. Label, dekho. Years. 1990, 1991, 92, 93, 94, 2011. Okay, till 2011, Sachin Tendulkar's career.
Yes.
Bar graph is shown on this screen. This is the x-axis. Now look at the y-axis. That is vertical line. The runs are given. Okay. Look at the label. Label written on the black bold line. Runs 200 runs, 400, 600, 800, 1000, 1200, 1400, 1600, 1800, and 2000. Okay. And run in bracket. The 50 number is given and 100 number is given. 50 means 50 and 100 means centuries. Sachin did. Okay. 1989, 00 is given. It means 0 50s and 100 zeros. Okay. In 1990, Sachin started 50 runs. Okay.
Yes.
Loco, it means that you understood the bar graph. Now I will ask one question. Okay.
Yes, sir.
On which year Sachin did 9 centuries? On which year Sachin did 9 centuries and 7 50s?
Sir,
1990. Yes, very good.
1990.
Yes, very good. Very good. I have to clap on your answer. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
On 99. Okay. You under it means that Students, you understood that bar graph shows very important information. Okay. I think you will not seen that type of information before that. Okay. From 1989 to the 2000 alone, Sachin Tendulkar runs career. Okay. Now look next slide. On this next slide, we will see. Drawing a bar graph, okay? How to draw a bar graph? Look, let us take an example to see how the given data is shown as a bar graph. Example. My dear students, till now this time, we will learn bar graph and giving answers, okay? But we have not drawn the bar graph, okay? Now, how to draw bar graph with the help of pencil and scale? You have to take your width, pencil, scale, and graph paper is necessary, okay, to draw any bar graph. Information about the plants in nursery is given here. Show it in a bar graph, okay? Okay, some information of in a nursery, okay? Nursery of plants. Mogra plant, Zai plant, hibiscus plant, and chrysanthemum. Okay, there are four plants given. 70, Zai 50, hibiscus 45, and chrysanthemum 80. Take a bar graph. Okay, look at how to draw. Take a bar graph. Okay, how many points are given to understand how to draw a bar graph? There are 6 points. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 points are given. Okay, in the center, write the title of the title and number of plants. Draw the x-axis, y-axis, and mark O, their point of intersection. It means originating point. We already learned it is. Write the names of plants on x-axis at equal distances. The number of plants is divisible by 5. Take a scale. Okay, 1 centimeter is equal to 10 plants on the y-axis, as it can be easily shown on the bar graph paper. Okay. Write the scale in the top right corner, top right hand corner. Okay, scale kahan pe likhte hai, where to draw. Scale is drawn on the right hand corner. Draw a bar of appropriate height above the name of each plant on the x-axis. We already know bars are drawn on the x-axis. Now look at this a graph which is already drawn for you. Question also given: Mogra 70, Zai 50, hibiscus 45, chrysanthemum 80. You will see Mogra is how many plants are there in nursery? 70 plants. The Mogra bar is drawn till 70. Next plant is Zai. Zai is 50, which is drawn till 50. And the hibiscus 45, which is shown by the bold blue line, okay? Bold blue line shows the 45 plants in the nursery. And chrysanthemum, the highest number of plants in the nursery. How many plants are of chrysanthemum? Which is shown on the bar, that is 80. 80 plants of chrysanthemum, okay? And scale is on the right hand corner. On y-axis, 1 centimeter is equal to 10 plants. Understood? In this way, we can draw the bar graph. Okay, students? Now next.
Yes, sir.
Yes, you will sir. Come to know. Now I know. Okay. Look at the ecoticon. Says now I know. Every bar in the graph should be of equal width. Bar should be equal width. Now width sabka same hona chahiye. The distance between any two adjacent bars should be equal. All bars should be appropriate height. Height appropriate hi hona chahiye. Okay. Now look at the next point. My friend Matt. In newspaper and periodicals also some graphs are given which shows the information of that data. You have to know, okay? You can take information from newspaper also, some bar graph also given on various topics. Now we are moving towards the next slide. Okay, that last our question. The names and numbers of animals in a certain zoo are given below. Hello students, you like zoo? Zoo is a house of animals, you already know. Use the data to make a bar graph. Okay, this data is given of zoo. Animals, first row is of animals and second row is of numbers. How many animals are given? 4 animals, correct? No. 5 animals. Deer, tiger, monkey, rabbit and peacock. Deer, how many deers in a zoo? 20. Tiger, 4 tigers in a zoo. Monkey, 12 tigers. Rabbit, 16 rabbit. Peacock, 8 peacocks in a zoo. Okay, now we have to show this information on the bar graph. It is easy. Now take pencil, graph paper and scale. With the help of these 3 things, you will draw. Look at the next slide. With the help of question, we are drawn deer. How many deer? Okay, look at the bar graph. I will show you labels. These 2 labels, okay? X axis, Y axis and scale, okay? 1 centimeter is equal to 4 animals, okay? This is 1 centimeter, 4. 4 animals, 8 animals, 12 animals, 16 animals, 12, 20 animals, okay?
And deer is 20.
Look at deer. Look at a first bar of this graph, deer. How many deers in the 20? Now, draw the bar of deer till 20. 20 animals, it means 20 deers. Next, tiger. How many tigers? 4 tigers. The tiger's bar is drawn till 4, which is already drawn. Okay. Yes. Tiger. Now next is monkey. How many monkeys in the zoo? 12 monkeys. Correct? This is monkeys. Okay. 12 monkeys. Then monkeys bar is drawn till 12. Monkeys bar is drawn till 12. Okay. Now next is rabbit. How many rabbit? 16 rabbit. Okay. Rabbit 16. It means 16 rabbit in the zoo. And the last one is peacock. And peacock is our national bird. You already know. Peacock is our national bird. Everybody likes peacock. Its feathers also. Oh, okay. This bird is also in the zoo. Okay. How many peacocks in the zoo? 8 peacocks. 8 peacocks, okay. So the bar of peacock is drawn till 8. Okay. In this way, we have to draw bar graph. Understood, student? Anybody have doubt on these questions?
No, sir.
Now it's time to take a homework slide, okay?
Okay, sir.
Take a screenshot of this.
Sir, I will take. Sir, I was
you take a screenshot?
Yes, sir.
Sir, I am taking screenshot.
I am also.
Okay, thank you, beta. Okay, now students, anybody having doubt on bar graph?
No, sir.
If you have any doubt, please ask me.
No, sir.
Okay, very good, beta. Thank you for class and enjoying the class. Class and give me write down homework also of this question. Okay.